Hello, my dear friend. Welcome back to my channel. This is Junie's Plan With Me. August for me is kind of intense and busy. I think in the coming September, I need to take some time and clear my mind. So for the Buju theme, I decided to go with self-care. For you who's been busy and didn't get a chance to take care of yourself recently, I hope this video can be helpful or inspiring for you. The liner pens I'm going to use today are kindly provided by Tisa. The 72 color sets has open 4 tapes and are filled with water-based ink, coming with a wide range of options in a metal box and 3 layer trees. The colors I picked for today are A188 and A190. By the way, you can get 10% off with my coupons for the whole September buying this or other products in our Tisa store. I'll leave the link in the description down below for you to check out. Now let's get started. Grab a cup of tea or coffee if you want, because I'm going to draw one here as you may already see the pencil guide. So for the cover page, I picked a cozy scene of afternoon tea time in front of a window. If you remember, in July Buju setup, I did a studio tour on paper and my table is facing a wall due to the layout of my room, which limits the sunlight I can get from the front. So all of today's drawings are not based on my current room setup, but more like my dream home. You are very welcome to modify it based on your sweet home layout and decorations. Now I'm drawing my dream scene of a relaxing afternoon. Have a show or movie playing on the laptop, a cup of hot tea, a piece of my favorite cheesecake, and let the sun coming through the window shine on the notebook. I can imagine sitting there, completely immerse myself in the emotion and just relax. So self-care is important to maintaining a healthy relationship with ourselves. It means doing things to take care of our minds, bodies, and souls by engaging in activities that promote well-being and reducing stress. The cover page is the first thing came to my mind when I think of self-care. I just turned 28 recently, so I spent some time trying to figure out my life directions. As a new YouTuber, I've been giving a lot of pressure to myself even though this is still a small channel right now. It's been a while since last time I took a break and enjoyed the afternoon of doing nothing but refreshing myself. I know a lot of you are crazy busy, having a stressful job, or are too consumed with technology to make time for ourselves. Me time is definitely necessary. There are many ways of taking care of yourself. For me, everything starts from a relaxing afternoon and it's maybe different for you, so I'll go through some ideas in later spreads and hopefully it gives you some inspiration. As for the drawing, after outlining the main objects with the purple fineliner, I use the pink for the details, then go back again to add some overall contrast and wood texture for the table. Also add some shadows at the end. Then I use a dark purple Crayola super tape to draw the box around it and a light purple color for the title September. Under it, I also draw a small calendar using the same color set. On the left side, I choose the quote, "Don't forget to fall in love with yourself first." Sometimes we may feel guilty about taking the time required to take care of ourselves. Self-care isn't a selfish act. If you don't take enough care of yourself, you won't be in the place to give to your loved ones either. So remember, fall in love with yourself first. Okay, the cover page is done and now let's move on to the monthly view. I've been trying different layout for the calendar for the past few months, like vertical or horizontal style. I actually like them all, but for this month, I'm planning to go with the more traditional way. I use pink to lay out the weeks and then draw purple dots on the left corner for the date. Each section is about 5x5, but I decide not to draw the vertical lines to make it more clean and neat. Then use white gel pen to write down Monday to Sunday plus the date. On the right side, the scene I pick is the corner of my dream living room. Everything is well organized and laid out. Getting organized is often the first step to becoming a healthier you. Staying in a clean and neat environment allows you to have a better mood and positive attitude. A small change, like adding a new plant in the center of the room, can bring some fresh air and make the space more alive. Or placing your favorite art on the counter or on the wall visually brings you happiness every time you see it. I guess that's why I always want to organize my room and get rid of those messy cables behind my husband's desktop, which I finally did with his help recently. In today's fast-paced world, we tend to turn to the phones for entertainment or comfort, scrolling through news feeds that can contribute to our stress and anxiety rather than helping it. So my next suggestion is to try reading some books. You might be amazed at the difference it can make when you slow down instead of always looking at your phone. Not only can it help improve your mood, but it can also help you to stay more present and mindful. You can also create an area to keep the things you love, like a little collection of joy. Maybe a lovely succulent plant in a glass container with gold edge, a candle that brings peace to you, or a pure white plate with pretty accessories in. After finish drawing the three scenes, I'm adding my social media tracker on the right up corner and then add borders to all of them. I was planning to add another one for note, but eventually decided to continue the calendar line style for it. Now it's time for habit tracker and sleep log. This month I'm also migrating my mood tracker to this spread because I want to try writing diary in a separate notebook instead of one line per day here. Then my mood becomes more related to my sleep hours and habit complete status. As for the layout, I continue to use this simple and clean style, which is putting dates on the top as x-axis, then habit and sleep time as y-axis, except this time I also add mood on the left side of the times. Then on the right side, the first tip I have for you is exercise. I personally is not a fan of exercise, but I do notice the difference before and after working out. Exercise is as good for our emotional health as it is for our physical health. It increases serotonin levels, leading to improved mood and energy. In line with the self-care conditions, what's important is that you choose the form of exercise that you like. It could be weightlifting, bicycling, jogging, or yoga. The next tip may not work for everyone, but I found it really relaxing when I do laundry. I enjoy separating dark color and light color clothes as well as folding them after. Those are simple tasks that can bring me strong sense of accomplishment. I think this could also be part of cleaning and organizing your environment if that makes sense to you. If you watched the other September Plan With Me video in which I set up my husband's bullet journal, you'll know what I'm going to talk about next. Here I'm drawing a modified version of Pantograph, which leads to the next tip I want to share. Listening to music you enjoy does decrease levels of the stress hormone cortisol in your body, which counteracts the effects of chronic stress. Soothing jangled nerves is one thing, raising sagging spirits is another. Bright, cheerful music can make people of all ages feel happy, energetic, and alert. And music even has a role in lifting the mood of people with depression illness. So music is a way to bypass our rational side and get to touch in with the emotional life we often keep hidden. If you're not in a good condition, there's usually a way that music can help. The next page is my brain dump and Instagram plan. I don't remember if I shared this in my previous video before, but some of the comments were asking me why I set it up like this. So I figured that the layout is pretty much like how the Instagram page looked like. Then when I fill it in while posting, I start with the one from the right down corner and then continue from right to left, from the bottom to top. Eventually it'll turn out just like how it looks like on the phone, which can help me to visualize the overall look ahead of time. So yeah, I hope I explained this clear enough for you to understand. On the right side, I'll leave most of the empty space for brain dump, and then on the bottom, I have a series of kitchen/cooking drawings. Start with an apron and some baking gear in the first scene. Do you know that our brains are designed to feel satisfaction and joy when both physical effort and challenging thought process come together? In other words, you'll be happier when you prepare something. For example, food. At the area of the brain that control movements, emotion, and thinking are interconnected, doing activities that involve a number of those components fully engage the effort-driven reward circuit. But the lacking of effort-rewarding system in our modern age leads to feeling of dissatisfaction and depression. Growing, harvesting, hunting, and preparing food have been replaced by driving through pickup windows or sitting down in restaurants. Therefore, reintroducing simple tasks like cooking can make us less stressed, happier, and more fulfilled. At first, it might still feel like a chore, at least I know it was for me, but over time, I started to enjoy more and more. Boring and time-consuming vegetable chopping could become meditative, and that 1 hour of meal prep became a mindful experience that reminded me to put myself first and set myself up for success. My best friend enjoys peeling garlic, and by the way, for my husband, is doing dishes. So no matter you're good at cooking or not, I highly recommend give it a try. After adding the borders, this page is done. And finally, we're at the weekly spread. This time, I'm going to try a different type of Dutch door, which is cutting away top half of the page instead of the edge, and then use the bottom half for the notes. As you may notice, I accidentally draw the pencil guide on the first page, which needs to be cut away, so I'm going to keep it on the side for now and stick it back on the bottom page later. As you can see, for each page, I also leave a 2x5 extra part as a tag for each week, and then make sure that they are not overlaid. Then I color them with pink and purple and write down the week numbers with a white gel pen. The first week in September has 6 days, so plus the note section, I divide the space into 7 parts. I write down the date and the days of week with a pink fineliner pen and then use purple one to draw the boxes. For each daily box, it is 6x21. Similar layout for the next 3 weeks, except there are 8 parts, Monday to Sunday plus note. As for the last week, there are only 3 days, so I use the right side leftover as monthly summary and next month goal. Now let's go back to our drawing. The first one is actually a close shot of my makeup table. When was the last time you actually spent time taking care of your skin, and when was the most recent facial mask you did? I'm not sure about you, but ever since quarantine, since March, I barely spent any effort on my face except very simple daily routine. Not even mention doing makeups. The most recent time was probably for my wedding anniversary. We were taking photos at home, so I got a chance to touch my foundation, eyeliner, brush, and powders again. So my next tip is, no matter you're working from home or having your summer break, don't let your skin products stay there and collecting dust like mine. As for the right side, like I mentioned earlier, I accidentally drew it on the first page, so now I'm going to cut it out and glue it on the bottom page. The idea in this drawing is that after all day hard working, you deserve a hot bath. We take shower every day, but how long has it been since you take a bath last time? Jump into the tub, light fairy candles and incense, put on some chill playlist on Spotify, and sit in the bath with your fairy thoughts, bath bombs, or essential oil. Yep, that's definitely the best part of self-care day. Plus, having a relaxing bath before going to bed will help you to reduce your stress levels, release all the tensions you have piled up during the day, immediately increase the quality of sleep you'll be getting. Besides that, I also draw a scene of next to the sink taking care of my hair. I've been losing hair crazily these days, probably related to the pressure I'm experiencing. Anyway, hair oil is also helpful for a good sleep. Just like previous pages, now I'm adding purple waters to all of them, and then on the left side, I'm going to add a small calendar that can serve all the weeks. Before the final flip through, I want to give a special thanks to my new Patreon members, Christina and DJ. I really appreciate your support and love. In my Patreon community, you can find digital version of all my bullet journal spreads as well as more bonus content. I'll leave the link in the right-up corner and description down below for you to check out. So yeah, that's all the spreads I want to share today. There are more self-care ways you can do besides what I mentioned here, and I also have another cat doodle video talking about it if you're interested. No matter where you are and how you've been, I truly hope, my dear friend, you can fall in love with yourself and take care of yourself. If you like this video, please click like and subscribe. Also, don't forget to turn on the bell. Thank you for watching. I hope you have an amazing September. I'll see you very soon in my next video.